And while you may have heard the term atmospheric river before when it comes to weather on the West Coast, you may be wondering what it actually means.
Yeah, certified first warning meteorologist Brooke Silvering joining us now to explain what this weather phenomena is and what causes it, Brooke.
All right, thank you, Tiffany. Atmospheric rivers aren't technically rivers, but it's a lot of moisture in the atmosphere. They're roughly 250 to 375 miles wide and can be as long as 1,000 miles. They form over tropical areas where warm ocean water temperatures cause water to rise, then strong winds carry the water vapor across the atmosphere and over land. These rivers are notorious for transporting an abundance of moisture that leads to significant precipitation events. Even heavier precip can fall if the moisture is lifted by mountains or a storm system. Atmospheric rivers also have a classification system, much like hurricanes or tornadoes. A Category 1 is considered to be weak and can lead to beneficial results, like much-needed rainfall, while Category 5 is considered to be hazardous. Atmospheric rivers are common in the western United States and can contribute to half of the annual precipitation on the West Coast. Reporting in studio, I'm meteorologist Brooke Silvering.